Hello, in this video series, we're going to learn how we can process audio signals for training machine learning or deep learning models. You may be familiar with computer vision applications that use images as inputs and then extract features from those inputs to train deep learning models, and then finally to do some things like image classification or image segmentation. The overall pipeline is still the same for audio processing. So we have audio as an input, and we extract features. Obviously, the features here are going to be different than the features that we extract for the images. And then we are going to use those features to train deep learning model, and then use those models for whatever purposes we want to. In this video, we're going to focus on feature extraction from the audios. And we will be doing that in Python. So I will go through a little bit of theory, but mostly focus on how we can extract those features in Python. So let's get into it. The agenda is mainly focused on feature extraction using Python. And then I do have some terminologies here. Don't get confused with those. We'll go through them in detail as we walk through the code. These are, again, some of the terms that we will be talking. So we'll talk about the STFT windowing, spectrograms, MelSpectrograms, decibel scales, and all of these things. Don't worry if you're not familiar with these, because I will mention what they are and try to explain to some extent and refer to some of the sources that really do a good job at explaining them in depth. Okay. Before we get into the details, let's understand some very simple things about, or basic things about, the signals in general. So any signal can be analyzed in either time domain or the frequency domain. What we mean by that is, if we take an example of the picture on the left, so we have a sine wave that is composed of just one single frequency. The graph on the top is just the time signal shown in the time domain. So at every time, x-axis is time, so at every time it tells us what is the amplitude of that signal. Then the signal below, the graph below, is the frequency representation of that same signal. Because this signal is composed of just one frequency, in the frequency graph, we see just one line, because it's just one frequency that is present in the signal. So this is the time domain, and this is the frequency domain of the same signal. Now, let's move on to a little bit more complicated signals. So on the right, we have a signal that is composed of three separate signals. So we have three separate signals which of three different frequencies and amplitudes, and they're superimposed. And the resulting signal is the graph in the middle. And then if we want to know what does the signal look like in the frequency domain, we would get three different lines. So on the x-axis is the frequency, and then we get three different lines basically telling us what frequency is present in the signal. So this looks simple so far. By the way, I just want to mention, in order to go from the time domain to the frequency domain, we have a formula, and then which helps us to transform from the time domain to the frequency domain, and that process is called Fourier transform. Now, things are not too bad for the signals that are simple looking like this. We have formulas to transform from one domain to the other. But when we have complicated signals, like such as this one, this is an audio signal, and it is not periodic, and it contains many different frequencies over, so different frequencies present are different at different times. So for these, just applying the formula and taking the Fourier transform is not as simple as it was for the simple signals that we saw in the previous slide. So we have another technique. Well, not another technique. We do Fourier transform in parts, and it's called short-term Fourier transform, which we'll discuss in detail a little bit. But in this slide, just want to emphasize that for complex signal that is not periodic and that has many frequencies, the frequency domain, a frequency domain analysis, or the frequencies, I guess I'll just say spectrogram, is going to look a lot busier than what it looks for the simple signal. So this image on the right is just the frequency content present in this signal. So how do we take the Fourier transform of this signal that is not periodic? So we do it in this way. So we have this entire signal. We break this signal into equal segments, and then we take the Fourier transform of all those segments. As you probably are seeing already, there is something called window length. So what that is, if we just take the Fourier transform of each segment, then we get into a situation where we have spectral leakage. In order to prevent that, we have a technique called windowing, and there are several types of windows predefined. So what we do is we take a signal, break it down, and multiply each segment with the window, and then whatever the resulting signal is, we take the Fourier transform of that, and then when we stack those Fourier transform of each of these segments, that's what gives us the spectrogram. Let's see how to do all of this, what we have studied so far in Python. So let's get to the code. The important library that we need to process audio signals in Python is Librosa. You don't need all of these, but you definitely need the ones that I have highlighted above. So first thing what we do is we load the audio signals. So we just use librosa.load, and then we specify the file name, and then we specify the sampling rate. So sampling rate tells us how many samples we want. How do we want to break down that analog signal? How do we want to discretize it? So in this case, 32,000 means 32 we will get after we load this into Y vector, we will get 32,000 samples per second. That's how this audio will be broken down into. So first we load it into a vector called Y. It's just a time series data at this point. And then we can either extract features from this time domain signal itself, or we can transform this into the frequency domain and extract features in the frequency domain. In this video, we're going to focus on how we can extract features in the frequency domain. So let's just keep going. So first thing we need to do from the signal that we have, which is in time domain, is to convert that into the frequency domain. And as we saw in the slides before, the way we do that is using Fourier transform, but the way Fourier transform is applied in Librosa is through STFT. It's called short-term Fourier transform. And if you go back to that picture again, there are several things here going on. We need to first define how do we want to divide this signal? Do we want overlapping segments or non-overlapping? And how much should they be overlapping? And also how many samples should be in each of the segments? So all of that we specify when we take the STFT of a signal. We specify samples we want in each segment, whether they should be overlapping segments or not, and the window type and the length of the window itself. So when we apply that STFT on that time domain signal, we get a spectrogram. So spectrogram again, on the y-axis is the frequencies, on the x-axis is the time, and most of it is really dark, and I'll explain that why that is, but there are some spots here where you see some colors. So these colors correspond to what is the strength of that signal at a particular frequency and a time. For example, in this case, here at the lower frequencies, we have some signal content that has more strength compared to rest of the graph, because rest of the graph is really like all basically silence or something that's not, nothing is present there for those frequencies. All right. And then because this spectrogram as is not really readable, like we cannot really infer frequency content properly. So What we do is we convert this spectrogram to something called MelSpectrogram. What MelSpectrogram is? It's basically we are going to be changing the scale of the frequency from hertz, I should say linear, to a Mel scale. You don't have to worry about how we do that because it's basically this formula according to Wikipedia. We take this frequency and then we convert that into the Mel scale. But the process is not as simple as just applying this formula. So there's a lot going on behind that, and I will refer to some of the references that are going to explain that really well. But for now, what Mel spectrogram is, we are converting the spectrogram from the linear scale to a Mel scale. So when we do that, we get something that's a little bit better than the spectrogram in the linear scale. And the way we do that in Librosa is basically we use something called feature.melspectrogram, and then we need to specify several things. Thing that is new here is mel bins, which again, if you want to understand what this number is, which is actually really important, then you should definitely read more into what is a Mel spectrogram and how do we generate it, and I will provide the links below for that. Now, so this spectrogram, Mel spectrogram, is a little bit better than the spectrogram in the linear domain, and as we can see here, we have frequencies that are 0 to 16,000. Here, the frequency is still in hertz, but we have different bins here. So that's where you get the Mel bins from. So this is still not readable. So in order to make it readable, we will convert the amplitude to a log scale. So we'll convert this spectrogram to decibels, and then we call that log Mel spectrogram. And the way we do that simply is whatever spectrogram we have here, which is a Mel spectrogram, we apply this function called power to dB and convert that into log scale, whatever the amplitudes are here. And what we get is a log Mel spectrogram, which is somewhat readable. I mean, there we see patterns here that, at, for example, at time this, frequency this, we have this strength. The color code here is 0 is the highest strength signal, a part of the signal, and as you go down is, you know, the strength of the signal goes down, and negative 80 is like silence. So that's how we go from time domain to the frequency domain. And what we have done in the frequency domain is basically we went from the spectrogram to Mel spectrogram to log Mel spectrogram. Now, I know I went through this really quickly, but I just wanted to show how we can extract features in the frequency domain using Python, and I will share the Python code in the links below. I hope this helped. Please feel free to ask any questions, and I would be happy to answer those. Thank you.